It's only small, but that is what's got the part is the brains of the operation.
Hello and welcome to another video. Now I know there is a 99% people that haven't subscribed. It's free to subscribe. I've got 110,000 views, actually more than that now actually. So if you could just click that subscribe button, spread the word, and this is going to be a good video, because basically when I went to work in Devon on this reality show, I had to basically assist, run around for a sound supervisor and four sound recordists who had basically a mixer, like recorder, a boom and all this stuff, and all radio mics and all these different sound gears to record the reality star participants. I had to mix a little bit, and I got quite into it. I was like, you know what? To progress, I need to learn this gear again, get it better. So this sound device is 633. So I thought, right, well, I need power as well. So I got some batteries, the charger. I need something to plug it in, and then I need a microphone because how am I going to test if it's working? Then I need a wind thing, a wind jammer for outside. I need a pole. I need this, and then I need some radio mics, because most people now need to have iPhones on people. I need to put the pole over the head that's over there like that, so they can pick them up. So I thought I might just buy a whole general setup, so when I'm not boom hopping, I can go and do adverts, and I can do sit down interviews like this, and be good at it, and also be good for learning the sound devices system, for if I'm on set and the mixer or whatever says I just need to go away for 10 minutes, can you jump on for me? I can be like, yep, I know how to use it, sweet, I know how to do it all. They'd be back, he'd be like, nice one, thank you, James. So I make myself more employable, and people will come and they can rely on me, basically. So first of all, what I did was people kept saying, have you got a pole? I was like, no. So the first thing I got was, I got an ambient pole. This was about £500 with the case. It's 4 meters long, and which is perfect for me. I don't need anything any bigger, I don't think. It's a sound recorder, so I won't need anything bigger than this. And this is a good thing to protect it as well. So I got an ambient QP5 100, and it's basically just over a meter closed, just over 4 meters extended. Perfect. And this is brand new ambient pole. I got that. Let's see what else we've got.
What is in the box? Well, obviously you need a mixer, but you need something to power it. So I got these batteries here. Power it, and you can see how much power is in it because it lights up four batteries. So this, I charged this for the overnight, because you can charge two up at once. I got that. So I'm happy with that. Stingray bag for it. And yes, it's got a little, basically is where you put the mixer. And the mixer is in there, is in this box here. So this is the Stingray bag. Then you've obviously got two cables with it, one 5 meter and one 3 meter. Most of the time, a 5 meter cable will be enough, because the pole is 4 meters long. I'll never really need to do 4 meters long. Go down my arm and into the actual mixer itself. So, to be honest, 8 meters worth is plenty. Then, like I said, you've got a shoulder strap, but when you've got a load of weight on, you don't want a shoulder strap pulling your neck down. So, I got this harness. Your back, and spreads the weight over your back, as opposed to these are nothing. These two, and these boxes here are what the batteries came in. I had to charge them up, and these are Swift NP1 batteries. They basically help you power most of the things that are in your bag for most of the day, or you might have to change them over at dinner time and charge the other one up while you're doing, just because it just, rather than using loads and loads of batteries, you should use one that's more of a high powered one. So this goes back in there. Came with these are COS 11s, There you go. Lavalier microphone, COS 11s. They're pretty good. There you go. Sanken microphone limited, 1.8 meters long. Oh, this is my microphone. Oh, this microphone here, 416, is industry standard. This was about £1,000.
Now here is the microphone inside its cradle. Now you may be wondering why I've got a piece put a piece of white tape on the end of this fluffer. Most time when you're on set, they turn the lights off and they get the sparks, or which they call the lighting department, to light a scene. If I'm dipping in and I see the white, I can see whether I'm in shot or out of shot. In shot or out of shot. What happens with there is you're catching the air coming out of your mouth. You don't put it over your head, because then you're basically effectively booming your forehead, and that's not where you don't speak through your forehead. You speak through your mouth, so you effectively have it a little bit like there, just in front of the mouth, and then it catches what you're saying. Whereas if you're over there, it won't catch anything about you. Some of them have got a bigger polar pattern, so they'll be able to catch it. This one, it'll only do it if it's in front of your face. So there you go, that's why these are so good. They're industry standard. This little piece here, this little thing here, is actually where these batteries, get off, these batteries here plug into there, and then you can use these little ports that are on here. That shoe there, that plugs into your mixer, and you can distribute the power through those extra things here, and you can, there's a little switch on next to there and there, so you can, if you only wanted to say use one receiver and you didn't want to use the other one, you could just flick the switch there and it isolates that, or it isolates that one. That 416 will go into this Rycote windshield, and it'll use this when you are outside. When you're not outside, you take that off, that little, I call it a blimp, because it looks like a blimp, basically, that's in the sky. And that's that furry thing, basically,
that left me when I was editing the video about the windjammer, from Rycote, the blimp, as I called it. I realised that it had gone out of focus, so you couldn't tell what I was saying, so I've had to delete it. So, basically, this is the, it's set up now. Basically what this does is, this fur catches the wind before it enters into the blimp, which then, before the sound enters into the microphone. So basically it stops, if you're outside, this is what you have on your pole, and it's quite windy. This catches the wind, stops the wind, dampens the wind without it going over what you're saying. It's nice and clean, like this dialogue.
They're Sennheiser G4s. They didn't come with that, isn't the cable it came with. That is not the mic it comes with. But as you can see, it was that. That is the transmitter. That's the receiver. And it's EW100s, as you can see when it focuses. And that's not the my frequency range. I've gone for 606 onwards. But this is the EW100s, which basically actually is EW112. These are very, very versatile. What happens is that says it's on, and obviously when it gets that frequency, the green light comes on, and it tells you the frequency is very good. Obviously, both has to be the same frequency, and I got two of those.
Ha ha! The beast,
my mixer. This is just a beautiful little thing. It's only small, but that is what's got the power, that is the brains of the operation.
That's my power, that is very effectively my setup. Now I'm going to put it into the bag and then show you what it's all like, kit set up inside. Well, that is my setup. So that is the kit I've bought so far. That's my new kit. I can't wait, I'm so happy I've got it. I'm going to set it all up. Hope you like this video. This is basically what you need for a beginner starter kit for any
sound Recordist beginner kit, that's a general kit. Stuff you get next would be stuff like a time code, more wireless microphones. So all I can say is thanks again. Hope you like this. It was informative of what you need. Once I wire it all in, I'll show you how it's all got to be done. Thanks again. Don't forget to subscribe, click the notification bell, like, comment, and just be positive. This is a great thing for me. I didn't think when I left university, 2017, which is 4 years ago, and when I started, when I went to university in 2015, that within 7 years I were buying all this gear, and I've finally got a lot of kit that I can hopefully go somewhere with and do something with. So I hope you like this video. Press that like button, and I'll see you all very, very soon for another amazing video. Bye bye.